ShireSociety.com.
What can you do all by yourself?
Hello, this is Ron Paul with your weekly update for Monday, May 27th. Common Core nationalizes and dumbs down public school curriculum.
Are you placed under arrest?
You're under arrest.
In addition to shredding civil liberties, launching a utopian global war for democracy, and going on a spending spree that would make LBJ blush, the so-called conservative Bush administration dramatically increased federal control over education via the No Child Left Behind Act. During my time in Congress, I heard nothing but complaints about this law from teachers, administrators, and most importantly, students and parents. Most of the complaints concerned No Child Left Behind's testing requirements, which encourage educators to teach the test. Sadly, but not surprisingly, instead of improving education by repealing No Child Left Behind testing and other mandates, the Obama administration is increasing national control over schools via the Common Core initiative. Common Core is a new curriculum developed by a panel of so-called education experts. The administration is trying to turn Common Core into a national curriculum by offering states increased federal education funding if they impose Common Core's curriculum on their public schools. This is yet another example of the government using money stolen from the people to bribe states into obeying federal dictates. Critics of Common Core say it dumbs down education by replacing traditional English literature with informational text. So students will read such inspiring materials as studies by the Federal Reserve Bank of San Francisco, the EPA's recommended levels of installation, and invasive plant inventory by California's Invasive Plant Council. It is doubtful that reading federal reports will teach students the habits of critical thinking and skepticism of government that the founders considered essential to maintaining a free republic.
New Hampshire did adopt the English and the math. So right now we have English and math standards in our school, Common Core.
Like Obamacare, Common Core, now dubbed Obamacore by some, has sparked a backlash in the states, leading some to propose legislation prohibiting state participation in the scheme. I hope these efforts lead to states not just opting out of Common Core, but opt out of No Child Left Behind and all the other federal education programs as well. Parents can also effectively opt out of programs like Common Core by seeking alternatives to government education. It is no coincidence that as federal control over education increases, the quality of public education has declined and more parents have chosen to homeschool. To support these parents, I have established my own homeschool curriculum. Unlike Common Core, we do not dumb down any of our offerings. Instead, the goal is to provide students with a rigorous education in history, math, English, foreign languages, and other core subjects necessary to a well-rounded education. Unlike the top-down model of nationalized education, the homeschool curriculum is designed to encourage maximum input from parents and students. While the curriculum will reflect my belief and interest in Austrian economics, libertarian political theory, and the history of the struggle against state power, the curriculum is being carefully designed to not show bias toward any one religion. I hope all parents of any faith or no religious beliefs at all will feel comfortable using this curriculum. I believe it is important for those of us concerned with education and liberty to fight our battles locally. We must oppose further encroachment on the autonomy of local public schools and work to roll back existing interference while encouraging and supporting the growth of homeschooling and other alternative education movements. The key to restoring quality education is to replace the bureaucratic control of education with a free market in education. Parents should have the freedom to select the type of education that best suits their child's unique needs.
The old world is collapsing, and it's going to take its slave driver governments with it. But what will rise up in their place? In New Hampshire, the Shire Society has a plan, a thriving web forum, and a history of action.
He didn't take long to come up with a plan.
You can sign up right now at ShireSociety.com.